Conference Freshman of the Year. No surprise there. Andrew Wiggins has been a star in his freshman campaign in Lawrence. Just putting in 30 points yesterday against Oklahoma State in the quarterfinals. He and Kansas taking on Iowa State moments away in the Big 12 semis right here on ESPNU. Matt Schick along with Adrian Branch. It is Kansas. It is Iowa State in this Big 12 conference tournament in Kansas City as we take a look at the brackets and what we've got. 1 versus 4. Then we've got Texas, which absolutely dismantled West Virginia. And then Baylor, which got past Oklahoma. So KU and Iowa State just moments away here on ESPNU. Kansas looking for their 10th Big 12 tournament title and their 4th in the last 5 seasons. Andrew Wiggins, without Joel Embiid, he was good before Embiid went out. He's certainly taken on a new role with Embiid's absence.
Well, they're showing the star power, and we were talking about him as a preseason first-team All-American, but he's gotten the wake-up call. He's now assertive. The game comes easy to him, and you can't tell by his facial demeanor whether he's up by 10 or down by 10, but he's got an easy flow. He can rise up, got an excellent vertical, and this is what Bill Self says, he leaves you wanting more. Well, he's answered the call. This was a huge game they had against Oklahoma State. He's been dominant, hard to guard, but he allows his teammates to flow, and then he's got that spurt where he can take over a game.
71 points in his last two games. That includes the win over Oklahoma State, the loss to West Virginia. We look at that shot chart for his performance against Oklahoma State, and 9 of 17 from the floor. Only took 6 perimeter shots, doing some damage in the paint, being a little more assertive without Embiid there.
Even before he was assertive, he's outstanding on the fast break, so he can get out in the open court. You want to get him that, but then you want your best perimeter player taking shots. He's knocking down shots. They give him an opportunity to take shots, and if you look at his teammates, even though he's a freshman, they allow him to be great. They give him permission to be great, to be assertive.
He's the Big 12 Freshman of the Year, the Big 12 Player of the Year. Melvin Ejim has been terrific. Another double-double in yesterday's win.
This young man led the conference last year in rebounding, has improved every year he's been there, and he's been hard to guard in Fred Hoiberg's system. That's what their bread and butter is, trying to get a mismatch on the offensive end. If it's a big guy, I'll take him outside to the three-point shot. If it's a little guy, he'll try to post him up. So it's like a baseball pitcher that you don't know when the curve is coming, to change up, or the fastball. Got that many pitches.
This is a Kansas team that swept the regular season series between these two teams. Melvin Ejim, there he is, Big 12 Player of the Year. He'll be wearing a uniform very shortly as we get set. We'll get you up to tip. KU, ISU. All right, championship week rolls on here on ESPNU. Some other games going on right now. VCU and Richmond in the A-10. Of course, we had a big upset earlier with St. Louis going down to St. Bonaventure. And Wisconsin and Minnesota in the Big Ten. We'll keep you up to date on all those. See you at half. Out to KC.
We're watching championship week. Presented by Dick's Sporting Goods.
Welcome to the Phillips 66 Big 12 Championship. Folks, we have reached the semifinal round. Another huge crowd on hand here at the Sprint Center in Kansas City. And this should be a dandy. Iowa State and Kansas, two of the best teams in the deepest conference all season long. Both with big victories yesterday to reach the semifinals. And then tonight, it'll be Baylor against Texas. Baylor coming the hard way. They had to take out the second seeded team, Oklahoma, after winning the previous night against TCU. Welcome, everybody. I'm Brett Musburger. Pleased to be with Fran Fischel and Holly Rowe will be joining us. You know, Fran, these have been great wars between these two teams, but I've got to point out, Kansas has beaten Iowa State five straight times.
And the Iowa State players know that, Brent. They told us today at the shoot-around, if you're going to win the Big 12 tournament title, you might as well go through the Jayhawks.
Well, let's take a look now at the principal financial group edge to the game.
Well, obviously, rebounding will be a big factor. Kansas without Embiid, obviously guarding Andrew Wiggins, who's been sensational. Kansas needs more than Wiggins on the offensive end, and they have to really buckle down on the defensive end because Iowa State presents mismatches.
Andrew Wiggins has been magnificent, 71 points in the last two games.
He really has, Brent, starting to grow into his own and grow into what we all expected, which was a sensational freshman. He had a great year coming into this week. It's getting even better, and boy, has he carried Bill Self's team. He's now become the go-to guy. This was a big basket down the stretch against the Cowboys.
Which leads us to tonight's Sonic Showdown. Would you believe it? A battle of a couple of talented Canadians. That's right, Melvin Edgem of Iowa State. He was the player of the year in the Big 12 Conference, and against Kansas State, he put up 24. Wiggins, of course, with the big 30. And now, Holly Rowe, are the two Canadians going to guard each other at all tonight?
Well, that Canadian connection is going to be connected tonight. That's right. Melvin Edgem has usually been guarded by Perry Ellis when Kansas has played them in previous meetings. But they noticed that on dribble handoffs, when Andrew Wiggins would switch on Edgem, he was a little more equipped to handle the big man out on the perimeter. That's what we'll see tonight.
So here they come, Holly. Iowa State with the first possession. Mike Stewart, Doug Sermons, Terry Oglesby, our officiating crew. Morris, who is very efficient, sends it into the corner. And, of course, a player to keep an eye on is out in that backcourt, DeAndre Kane, who fouled out. Niang with the first shot, a little bit short. Tharp runs it down, and here come the Jayhawks. Pulls it up off the transition. And in and out into the hands of Dustin Hoge, who might have been the unsung hero of their victory yesterday against the Wildcats.
So many weapons Fred Hoiberg has, and he utilizes them in spaces that they can be effective, like right there.
You called it, Fran. Niang stepping out, nails that first three ball. He can work inside, and there you saw outside, and that was only a two.
Well, they have done this. They're going to utilize their best offensive players to their strengths.
So Hoge is out on Wiggins. Hoge has length. He sort of lost him a little bit there. And a turnover. That's one thing that plagues the Jayhawks. And there's their first turnover of the game as you check in on the starting lineups, the familiar five for these two teams. Of course, Joel Embiid missing, and that means that Tariq Black, number 25, is the big man. He's a transfer from Memphis. Iowa State with the first hoop in this game. That's Kane right there. Keep an eye on him. What Niang can do, a great dish. Hoge finishes. Beautiful setup.
Absolutely. That's what makes him so effective, Brent. scoring inside and out, and also the catalyst in terms of his passing. The reason they'll double team in the post, Iowa State, is to stay out of foul trouble. They do not want Edgem Hogue and Niang getting in foul trouble one-on-one.
Edgem is taking Perry Ellis down low, forced him out of there. Wiggins misses his first shot of the game. He forced it against Hogue, and now Kane comes back. Thought about it. Niang back outside, rattles out.
I think you can drive Kansas today because of the lack of that shot blocking inside. Watch the double if Ellis gets it.
Seldon up over the top, and that's a three.
That would be huge, Brent. Wayne Seldon quietly has had a terrific freshman year.
Kane open, knocks down his three, the answer.
That's a guy that shot 28% from behind the arc for three seasons at Marshall, and Fred Hoiberg has helped that jumper immensely.
Right now, keep an eye on Hogue, who's doing a good job on Wiggins, and so Ellis drives it to the glass that time for the field goal. But Wiggins cannot shake Hogue yet. Niang is open deep off the iron. Ellis runs it down for the Jayhawks.
Remember, Niang was 0-for-9 from behind the arc in that first meeting in Ames.
Wiggins is camped, and the other 22 keeping an eye on him. Seldon, not this time, tracked down by Edgem. This is Morris. He was a quiet assassin also against Kansas State. Here's Hogue outside over Ellis, and he knocks down another three ball. Iowa State on fire in the early going.
Hogue is very sneaky behind the arc. There's so many little things for the Cyclones.
Ellis going to drive to the left side on Edgem. So he scored on the right side of the glass, and now the left side.
This Seldon-Kane matchup is terrific. Two big, strong guards.
In the paint, Niang spins. Defensive rebound by Wiggins. Hogue with Wiggins up over the top with that beautiful move ahead. Tarik Black with an offensive rebound. Knocked free, ball on the ground, battle for it. Cyclones have got it. Edgem came up with a loose ball. Here's Morris coming up on Tharp. Knocking it down, another J.
This freshman from Michigan, very impressive. Former Mr. Basketball, has played a ton of big games in his career.
This is the start that Fred Hoiberg and the Cyclones wanted. Brilliant. Tarik Black trying to quiet the crowd, and Kane smashes it out of bounds. Tremendous crowd on hand. We'll be right back after this message from your friends at Phillips 66. It's now 13. They reviewed that long shot by Niang at the start of the game. It was a three. And four Iowa State starters have scored, and Edgem has not yet taken a shot. That was the picture that the referees saw during that timeout. Joel Embiid, not playing again in this tournament, has a back injury. And Fran, right at the beginning, we see how much they miss the big presence.
Well, exactly. And look at their field goal percentage. It's not up dramatically, but even over 40% this year. That's the first time in Bill Self's 11 seasons that they haven't held opponents under 40.
Now let's see what Wiggins is going to try to do. How they're going to shake him loose. Big screen. Let him drive. Come to the left side. Rebound. And that is yanked down by Iowa State's Daniel Edozie, who's seen his first action this year against the Jayhawks. Did not play in either of the regular season games. He's 6'8", big body out of Compton, California. Fran, give us a little update on him.
Well, exactly. I think what Fred Hoiberg is doing right now is making sure he goes deep into this bench, understanding it's a long game. This young man, junior college transfer, only played in 18 games, but a big enough body to do some work inside.
Remember now, Edgem has yet to take a shot. Wiggins is on him, rises up. Couldn't knock that one down. Long rebound fielded by Selden, and here's Tharp. Traylor has checked in for Kansas, number 31. Attacks off the weave. Rebound by Black.
You know what, Brent? That's exactly the reason Bill Self wanted him when he transferred from Memphis.
Deep three. Kane knocks it down. Another three for the Cyclones.
I'll tell you, DeAndre Kane, what a monster season he has had. He has done it all in every statistical category.
Traylor attacks. Loose, battle for the rebound. Still loose, ball out of bounds, Iowa State. So there's DeAndre Kane, who is coming off, for him, a subpar game. But look at the career points.
Well, it's amazing, Grant. First 3 years at Marshall, he left there unceremoniously. Because he graduated, he was able to get an extra year of eligibility, immediately eligible at Iowa State. And who does a better job with transfers than Fred Hoiberg?
Yesterday, after that win, you may have seen the video on ESPN. Hoiberg brought the team around him, and he said, get plenty of rest. This is just a start. A lot of liquids, but stay off your feet. We've got two more games to play. And what a start, although that was a sloppy turnover. Fred Hoiberg, one of the best young coaches in all of basketball. 10-year veteran of the NBA wars. Does a fabulous job with the Cyclones. Mason has checked in, and this is a foul down away from the basketball. It's going to go against Iowa State.
Well, that foul is on Edozie, the young man we talked about. And early in this game, Fred Hoiberg would rather him pick up a foul or two than Hogue or Edgem or Niang.
Edgem takes a seat. Hoiberg rested him early yesterday against Kansas State, too. Now, Wiggins is 0 for 3, wide open. Selden off iron. Ellis couldn't handle it, and is fielded by Hogue, and down comes Niang for the Cyclones. Off the dribble. That's something he could do. Bill Self needs a timeout. He's livid. He's all over Ellis. This is not the kind of start that the 10-time league champion Jayhawks were looking for against Iowa State. A huge contingent here from Ames on hand, and this is the one they want more than any other, to snap that 5-game losing streak. They've played Kansas into overtime. They've gone down the stretch of several others, but they've never been able to close the deal in the last couple of years.
Well, we did that first game, Brent, up in Ames, when Andrew Wiggins went for 19 rebounds. That was the night George Niang went 0 for 9 from behind the arc. Second game at Allen Fieldhouse. closer than the 11-point score. But what you love about Iowa State is that Fred Hoiberg thinks outside the box. Here's his center bringing the ball up the floor, but he's not your typical post player because of his mobility. Good example right there.
Can you think of any other player in the country quite like Niang?
He is unique, Brent, and he's in the perfect spot. You remember what Fred Hoiberg did with Royce White a couple years ago? The only time Fred Hoiberg's team has beaten Kansas was with Royce White.
Kansas needs to get Wiggins going. Turns baseline, he's 0 for 4. Niang has trailer on him. He'll back him down. He'll come paint. And he traveled. He does travel.
Well, he does. He moves his feet quickly. And he didn't feel he did there. But I think he makes his move so quickly. And I think sometimes officials are not used to a big fella with that kind of agility.
Edgem returns for the Cyclones.
They're trying to isolate Perry Ellis at the elbow. Right now it's going to have to be Ellis and Wiggins.
Ellis jumps it over to Traylor, and Traylor with that sharp shot off the glass, and it makes it 18-11. Kane attacks. Rebound fielded by Wiggins. Wiggins being hounded. Double team. Help from Traylor. Here's Selden now into the paint. Off to the corner, and Mason, and hold on. There was a foul on the play. So we'll come back and sort that out. Looks like it was on Naz Long, who's just off the Cyclone bench. Six Big 12 Championship is part of Championship Week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Iowa State, an underdog in this game by a couple of hoops, jumps out to an 18-11 lead, and they have held the Jayhawks to 33% for the field, Brent.
Oh, that's right. Andrew Wiggins 0 for 4, Brent, but I like the way he's playing. Coming out quickly and attacking. Shots haven't gone down yet, but they will. But you got to remember, if you're Iowa State, you're going to hound this young man as much as possible to keep him from getting in a rhythm. Coming off a fabulous week of basketball. You pointed out earlier, 71 points the last two games.
And he had 30 of their 77 against Oklahoma State in that overtime win. Mason thought about the three, then puts it on the deck. And there's Wiggins, and he'll be on the free throw line. Niang's first foul.
Now that was all created by Wiggins' initial drive. And if there's one thing, Brent, that's really jumped out at me over the last month with this young man is taking the bull by the horns and accepting Bill Self's challenge to become Kansas's alpha dog.
And now he misses a free throw. Six-point advantage. Kane brings it down for Iowa State. As long, number 15, was terrific off the cyclone bench. Hogue is open and didn't stay down. Wiggins open floor and knocked away and out of bounds. Edgem was one of the defenders there.
Okay, you fans want a foul here, but more importantly, I just love the way Wiggins is attacking the basket. Early in the season, he had some trouble finishing those kind of plays. He did there, but love the effort.
Rises up on Hogue, didn't get the shooter's roll. Long rebounds, and now it's Kane again. Kane sees daylight, going hard. Not there. Defensive rebound, one and done. Perry Ellis. Seldon into the paint, attacking, and it's offensive foul is the call. Dustin Hogue is having a tremendous Big 12 tournament so far.
You know what I love most about him, Brent, is just throwing his body everywhere. Take a look now. He's going to establish, holds his ground. Seldon a little bit out of control.
He took a blow. Seldon's got a big body. Showed a little courage there. Looks a lot easier than it is on TV. Niang. Dribble. Has it knocked away and out of bounds? He traveled again. That's his second turnover off the traveling call and three for the team.
Well, Terry Oglesby, he's right on top of that. Niang's got to gather himself first.
You know, it's interesting that Hogue, because Wiggins has not taken him at the other side, he's had Edgem. So Hogue has also scored 5 points along with two rebounds.
And you normally think Edgem's the guy you got to stop, but Hogue's had a really good year.
Green now seeing some playing time. Here comes Wiggins. He's looking for his first basket of this game.
And Kansas passed up a shot of opportunity right there.
Dart back on the floor, drives, throws it up. Good rebound by Perry Ellis. Strong put back by 3-4.
Does he have great hands?
Well, a long pass, and that is what Wiggins can do. Gracefully run the floor and knock it out of bounds. And when you're struggling offensively, friend, contribute defensively.
Absolutely. Great closing speed. Morris with a good look up the floor.
Traylor being warned now of this play. Niang took the inbounds pass. Traylor cuts him off with his wingspan. Edgem fires his first hoop, and it's a three-pointer. It's 21-14.
He caught the freshman napping just a little bit, watching the ball on the other side of the floor.
Also on the floor, I mentioned that Brennan Green, he's number 14. Here's Traylor. Bill Self searching for some firepower. His star has been shut down. Here he comes, Wiggins, off the dribble, and he's coming back to the free throw line.
Now take a look. We highlighted how good a defender weak side Wiggins was yesterday. Watch him peeking at the ball, peeking. Too late. Got to be able to close quickly.
Edgem, the veteran, the old Canadian against the young Canadian, if you will. And Wiggins knocks it in. I'm sure they've played against each other a lot, Holly.
That's right. They're both from Ontario. I talked to Melvin Edgem before the game. He said, I've known Andrew since I was in about eighth grade. Andrew, of course, is younger. They've spent some time, worked out together, so they know each other's game very well. We're seeing that in the defense today.
Of course, Andrew's dad, Mitch Wiggins, was an NBA player, and Andrew one of three. You see all the Canadians in this Big 12 tournament, Brent. All these guys are having outstanding tournaments so far, great years, but Mitch Wiggins has three sons. Mitch Jr. playing in Florida at a smaller school. Nick playing at Wichita State. and Andrew playing here tonight.
Yeah, they're one of Wichita State unbeaten coming off the bench. He's one of the regular rotation players for the Shockers, having an outstanding year, probably watching his brother here. Niang took it in.
Now you see how Fred Hoiberg creates space for Niang to operate.
Wiggins now watching from the sideline. Bill Self giving him a minute to regroup.
I think Ellis has got to get some touches here, either in the post or on the ISOs.
Tharp sends it over to Ellis, and Ellis will put it on the deck. Ellis has taken over offensively.
Yes, he needs to, Brent. He can hurt you inside and out. And you've pointed out already how good he is driving to both sides of the floor.
Jayhawks close to within five. Edgem being battled by Ellis. Edgem will come up over him. Couldn't score. Green with the rebound. Jayhawks lead pass. Selden kick it back outside. And now Ellis will shoot the long ball. Hits the three. Perry Ellis leading the Jayhawks.
His 8-3 of the season.
11 points for Ellis. Well, Phillips 66, fueling the neighborhood with performance gas and just about everything else, like we have been for the last 80 years. Phillips 66, proud to be here. And what a great sponsor they've been for the Big 12. Let's take another look at Perry.
Yeah, absolutely. Watch the versatility. The offensive rebound put back with his left hand. Then the drive to his right hand. Really well done. Soft off the glass. And only his 16th three-point attempt of the season. He's knocked in 8 of them. And I think he has to be the guy, with Wiggins struggling just a little bit, to take on the mantle, if you will, of being their go-to guy right now.
Well, we can't say enough about Dustin Hoge and the defense he did on number 22 there. So Wiggins will attempt to regroup and watch a little bit. Bad pass. Cyclones turn it over. Jayhawks going for the tie of the lead. Tharp down into the middle. Stuff ties it. Tariq Black. Long hits Niang. Niang wrapped around. Not there. They're missing him at the basket.
Nice.
And it's Ellis for the lead. Kansas battles back and is now up 25-23.
Hoiberg doesn't want to take the timeout because he just took one.
Cyclones have missed some opportunities at the rim. 2 feet away from the basket. Kane jump stop, keeps going. They miss again. The Jayhawk run. How long will it go? Tharp will drive in, throw it up. He's on the free throw line. Now Hoiberg is not happy. Niang pushes it back for the official. It was a timeout call. They're going to have to check here.
Well, Mike Stewart called the timeout. The technical, Brent, the same guy that threw Kevin Ollie of UConn out early in the year.
He says, are you kidding me about that call?
Big 12 Network game is brought to you by Phillips 66, proud to be here. Dick's Sporting Goods, every season starts at Dick's. Motel 6, the official economy lodging partner of Big 12 fans everywhere. The Principal Financial Group can help build, grow, and protect your financial future. GEICO, 15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance. And by Whataburger, swing by Whataburger today to pick up the newest all-time favorite, the Monterey Melts.
We welcome you back to Kansas City. There are several parts to this puzzle right now. A technical has been called on Fred Hoiberg, who initially was upset about this. Non-call on Black underneath the hoop. However, he got the technical when he tried to call a timeout. Niang pushing him back away.
What I don't understand is when an official misses a call, he's got to give the coach a little bit of leeway if he is going to argue. And in Hoiberg's case, he never gets upset.
That's the most upset I've ever seen Fred Hoiberg about anything.
You got to know, the officials have got to know the coaches as well as they got to know the players. It's very rare that Fred Hoiberg will lose his cool. Other guys in the league, it's the boy who cried wolf.
And the Jayhawks make him pay.
Well, Bill Self sitting there, he's just taking it all in.
And throughout this debate, he's been pointing at the shot clock. So now Tharp comes up. Holly, what's the situation? Why was Fred pointing? I know he was trying to get a timeout.
Well, he was upset because he was on the floor and got that technical foul, but he was on the floor because the timeout had been called and he was trying to get the officials' attention. Mike Stewart said, not right now, Fred, not right now. He wanted things to cool down. After everybody settled things down, Mike Stewart did go over, had a long conversation with Fred Hoiberg. But, Fran, to your point, Hoiberg never gets upset like that. There was a good reason he was out on the floor, and Mike Stewart probably should have known that.
You know what, Holly? That was like a six-point play because of the missed foul at the other end as well.
So the Jayhawks lead it 29-23 as a result of all of that. 7:15 remaining. Kane steps back. Badly miss on the three ball. The Jayhawks are in control right now.
The defense has been outstanding.
Greening knocks down a tray.
That's what he does. He's their designated long-range guy, and Bill Self gives him some rope.
Ed steps out. Quiets him for the moment. 32-26. The old veteran with a huge hoop for the Cyclones. They go inside, and that is a foul going the other way. Hogue was in the middle of things down there on the inside.
Now Black, I think, just was it Black, Brent, because he just pushed off with that left arm. If you're Iowa State right now, we talked about this at lunch today. Go inside and make the officials blow the whistle. Mike Stewart knows that things got a little bit out of control, so put the onus on the officials if you're Iowa State and try to get the ball inside. Don't settle for jump shots.
Knocked away from Niang, and Morris tracks it down. Kane was Selden on him on the inside. Going to come back again. And Tariq Black pulls away the miss.
Well, he's a wall. He did a great job of staying vertical.
Selden misses left hand, knocked away. And the foul is going to be called on Iowa State this time. And Selden's going to come to the free throw line.
You know, Brent, you mentioned Dustin Hogue and the job he does for Iowa State. How about the dirty work that Wayne Selden does for Bill Self?
No question. Well, today's game being brought to you by Puerto Rico Tourism Company. Live your own star vacation story. Puerto Rico, the all-star island. Visit seapuertorico.com. And just like that, the Jayhawks are in control.
Absolutely. You know what, Brent? They've been tremendous on the defensive end, especially in the paint.
Niang didn't get the roll. Battle for the rebound. And Ellis was tied up with Hogue.
Yeah, Perry Ellis took a shot from Hogue. He had inside position. And I think right now, if you're Iowa State, you must calm down on the floor. Got some veterans out there because Kansas over the last 5 minutes has taken control with outstanding defense.
The 2 foot shot, that's been the curse for the Cyclones.
No,
they have not been able to score down there from short range. Now, believe it or not, this is the 11th free throw for the Jayhawks as Ellis, who had only 9 yesterday against Oklahoma State, he got a dozen already in this game. The Jayhawks have shot, this will be their 12th free throw. Iowa State has not yet been to the line. You know that's eating away. And Holmberg over there on the other sideline, you just know that's burning away. He knows what that number is.
You know, in fairness, Brent, I thought they missed that one call when Black whacked them, but they're doing a good job of staying vertical, more or less. Not that time.
And one.
Yep. But I think you got to keep attacking if you're Iowa State. You must take the ball at those shot blockers inside. Black has done a reasonably good job of using his body, but you must. I thought last night, Brendan, in the Baylor Oklahoma game, that Oklahoma settled way too many jump shots, didn't attack Isaiah Austin inside.
Yeah, you pointed that out to me repeatedly.
You got size, you must go after size inside. Kansas has been really good defensively.
So Wiggins back on the floor. Traveling. Traylor turns it over. By Edgen. And Hogue was fouled underneath.
They call that foul on the floor, so there'll be no free throws. See, I like this, Brent. If you're Iowa State, take the ball at Kansas. It's a psychological thing. If the officials feel they may have screwed up on a call or two, they may feel bad about it. You know what? The only way they're going to blow the whistle is if you give them a chance to blow it.
That's 2 fouls on Traylor. Green replaces Traylor.
And that means Wiggins will go to the 4 spot, which you don't see too often. But without Embiid and a little bit of foul trouble and rest, see the Bruce brothers talking here amongst themselves, Black and Traylor. Two guys have played well together this year.
Down to the 5-minute mark. Jayhawks up by 6. Selvin rises up and knocks down a deuce.
Well, he's been really aggressive on both ends this whole tournament.
Morris's turn. The 3.
That young man, Morris, boy, he can really pass the ball, but he also knows about big moments. He lost 5 high school games in 4 years.
So Hogue sticking with Wiggins. off the iron. Morris now yanks a rebound down. Jayhawks are back defensively. Edgem on the drive, lofts one in.
That's how you must attack that Kansas defense right now, especially because they're small.
Ellis is doubled. Niang tightens up when he picks the dribble up. And now it's Wiggins looking for his first field goal. Got open daylight and knocks it down. Long pass now to Edgem, and Wiggins is back at the other end and one. That is smart basketball. Give it to the man whose man just scored. Remember, they're not guarding each other, so that allows Edgem to release. And Wiggins had to chase back and committed the foul. Folks, if you like emotional, tough, physical basketball, you've come to the right place. And we'll be right back after this message from your friends at Phillips 66.
Matt Schick here, coming up on the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. Oh, stunner for St. Louis. St. Bonaventure as Jordan Gathers knocks it down to take down St. Louis in the A-10. Other action going on right now, we'll update you at half. There's VCU up on Richmond. Providence looking to keep its NCAA tournament hopes alive, taking down Seton Hall in the Big East. A lot of action going on around the country. We'll see you at half.
.45 remaining as Edgem knocks down the free throw, and it's a two-point basketball game with the Jayhawks ahead of the Cyclones. Big 12 semifinal. Baylor and Texas will play in the next semifinal. The winners meet tomorrow night for the championship. Over the top, knocked away from Wiggins, and there's Hogue's length again, doing a fine job on Wiggins. And Perry Ellis has been the answer, right hand that time.
He caught Niang watching the ball. Perry Ellis cut right to the block. Perry Ellis has 7 games this year, Brent, with 20 or more, but he's also got 10 games in single figures. He's been inconsistent as a scorer for this team.
17 points here in the first half. Niang driving on him. There is that hook and one. So after not getting to the free throw line, now the Cyclones are making a living there.
Absolutely. They've started to attack the interior of Kansas. Watch the spin right here. And then the contact by Green on the backside.
So the game of runs continues. Iowa State with its second big burst here to climb back into this game. They can make it a one-pointer. And Niang does just that.
I think Fred Hoiberg got his point across.
Indeed.
Trying to spread the floor right here. Watch Ellis.
Niang with his hands full. Ellis up over the top, a little short, into Kane's hands now. Now it's the Cyclones looking for the lead. Hold. Jump stop off the glass. Now it's Bill Self's turn to take a timeout.
Well, he's going to talk about that defense because right now, Cyclones are shooting 50% or more from the field, and they've already got 43 points.
Remember, the Jayhawks built a 10-point advantage in this game. Fred Hoiberg called for that technical, four successful free throws, and it was the Jayhawks' turn to run. Holly, how was Fred's huddle that time?
Well, you know, in that last technical, there was a big point swing for Kansas. The game started to get away from Iowa State. So in their last huddle, Fred Hoiberg actually apologized to his team. He said, guys, that is my fault. We play with poise. I coach with poise. We have got to get back to being poised on that end. And he's trying to lead by example here.
And indeed, they have been poised. They have regrouped. And he's got some veterans out there. There are a lot of reasons why Edgem was the player of the year in this conference, and you could just watch his leadership. Remember, they missed a couple of bad shots. He went out and stroked a perfect three.
Absolutely, Brent. He's got a lot of experience, not only in the Big 12, but talk about international basketball, playing for his country. He played a lot of basketball last summer in the World University Games in Russia.
He's out on Green defending him.
Hope's got a piece.
He's just done an unbelievable job on Wiggins. But Niang has got his hands full with Ellis. I mean, Ellis has been on fire here today. 19 points.
Well, they need to start thinking about double teaming him again.
Over the top, Elliott. Kind of a dangerous pass that time. And on the turnover, Ellis coming again. A 21-point first half.
This reminds me of last year when he was a freshman in this tournament.
Made the all-tournament team.
Absolutely.
Jeff Withey was the MVP for the Jayhawks. Kane, three is good.
He's the real deal, Brent. What an addition. Best transfer in college basketball.
What a basketball game. What a tournament we've got here in Kansas City. Now it's Green's turn for the Jayhawks off the iron. Rebounded by Kane, whom you were referring to. The transfer from Marshall. Coast to coast. Not this time. Tap up. No. Got it. It's Kane from the left side. No. And again they missed.
Yeah, they sure did. Yep. Point blank. Great effort both ways. Kansas comes away with it.
Final minute.
Let's see if they double.
Hoge sloughs a little bit on Wiggins, keeping an eye on him. You can see on the right side of your screen now. He wants Edgem off of him. Hoge wants to jump on Wiggins. He does. Battles through the screen, and Wiggins with great move, able to get past him. They didn't switch off that screen. They battled through it, and Hoge couldn't stick with him.
And guess what? Kansas may still end up with the last possession of the first half because of that quick move.
That was Wiggins' best offensive move of the game.
Yes, it was.
Edgem steps out. No, Morris was going for it. It's going to be Cyclone basketball. Good hustle by number 11. It was knocked away from him and out of bounds. Final 9.9, and they did not get the second possession.
They did not. Now, if you're Iowa State, do you try to score quickly off your inbounds plays? Or do you get it in, set it up so that you get the final shot? I say get the final shot.
Landon Lucas will replace Green just to give a little bit more size, Bill Self, underneath. 6'10", freshman from Portland, Oregon for the Jayhawks. You've seen number 33. He's back to you defensively.
Shooter Thomas is in as well.
Niang puts it down on him for the right baseline. The size worked. So Self's decision pays off that time. There was a little more size against Niang. And I think Kane was hoping the time might run out. He's ready to chase that ball completely under the table over here.
Now, this is your classic NBA sideline out of bounds. Do you have something that's a catch and shoot? Iowa State does a great job with these plays, Brent. Watch for someone, watch for somebody slip into the basket. There it is.
It got it at the buzzer. And Niang, another point blank shot.
I've watched Iowa State work on those specials. They got exactly what they wanted, and he missed it.
Wow, what a great first half. And Coach Hoiberger's with Holly Rowe. Let's go to Holly.
Well, Coach, your team was in command of this game and then a technical foul. Just walk me through what happened. What were you trying to explain to the officials there?
Oh, we were just having a little conversation. It was nothing.
You were pointing to the clock, gesturing to the clock. Was there anything wrong there?
No, it had nothing to do with the clock.
Okay, yeah. Thank you. You guys had some great moments. You keep saying in the huddle, get back to what we were doing. What is it that you're doing effectively?
Well, I put some of that on me. I felt I got us a little bit sped up. You know, just when we're in control, we had pretty good moments. We know this is a game of runs. We know Kansas is certainly capable of going on big ones, but we feel we're capable of doing the same. Hopefully we can have great spurts in the second half and come out on top.
How do you change your defense on Ellis?
Well, he's doing a great job. We got to run some double teams at him. We got to be quicker when he catches the ball and make sure our rotations are crisp out of the double team.
Thank you.
Thanks, Holly.
Welcome into the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. Four questions for Holly there at the beginning of the half there.
Two of them he didn't answer.
That is true about the technical foul. That technical foul, part of a 23-5 run for Kansas. Iowa State withstood that. What a game we have so far. Matt Schick along with Adrian Brandt.
Well, it's been an excellent game right now. Offensively, both teams are getting what they want. And if you think about this, both teams are aggressive. Perry Ellis is carrying Kansas right now. He's been hard to guard. You heard the question about what they're going to do in the second half. Obviously, you've got to double team him hard and get back to the shooters and see who else is scoring, because 21 points, the next person is only 7 points, but a great first half.
And Andrew Wiggins so far, just 7 points, 2 of 8. From the floor. Here are your Big 12 brackets. What a score. What a game we have. 48-46 here at half. Both teams shooting better than 44% from the floor. Texas and Baylor coming up. Let's take a look at our tournament challenge resume brought to you by Allstate. Look at Kansas, what they've accomplished. They're a fairly good basketball team historically. Five Elite Eights. 2 Final Four appearances with those 10 NCAA tournament appearances, all under Bill Self, including that 08 national title. Go to ESPN.com and sign up for the tournament challenge. We know you will. Coming up, we will shift our attention to the ACC. Syracuse and NC State, the rematch. The Cuse trying to get hot.
This halftime report is presented by Buffalo Wild Wings, the official hangout for NCAA March Madness.
Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report.
To the ACC we go. ACC quarterfinals in Greensboro, Syracuse and NC State. Remember, Jim Boeheim's team lost 4 of 6 to end the regular season. Look at it. Their postseason started off right. C.J. Fair, Steele, Duck.
As far as proximity, this is like a home game for NC State, so they want to get back and play with the lead in this game.
Leonard Freeman, close proximity to the rim, jams that home. And Tyler Ennis to Trevor Cooney, knocking down the three. T.J. Warren, your ACC player of the year, he's got 11 at half, baby.
Made the adjustment. He was out there at the three-point line, but that's where he can do damage. One of the best scorers, obviously, in college basketball.
Jeremy Grant is also back for Syracuse. He's got 7 points, 6 rebounds at half for Syracuse. Pittsburgh, the other ACC newbie, they get another win in the ACC tournament. Take down North Carolina. They'll take on the one seed Virginia coming up tomorrow on ESPN. What about in the SEC, the quarterfinals in Atlanta, Kentucky and LSU, James Young. The three, Kentucky got back in this with some good defense.
Well, they tweaked their mindset coming in. They said they were going to be a more physical team, and Coach Cal, leading up to this tournament, let his guys go defensively.
Now holding the lead, there's Andrew Harrison to Young for the dunk. Kentucky up 10 at the half, looking for their 23rd win of the season. Straight ahead, we will shift our attention to Indianapolis. Big Ten tournament. Ohio State would need a big comeback for a big win. Welcome back to halftime in Indianapolis. You saw Ohio State get a big win. You saw Michigan get a big win. Minnesota, one of Joe Lenardi's first four out. Wisconsin still sniffing a one seed, AB.
Wisconsin's tough. You've got to beat them. They won't beat themselves, especially if you turn the basketball over.
DeAndre Mathieu.
Where's the defensive pressure right now? Where's the that's a miscue. You and I can play if it's like that.
Not a miscue. It's Mathieu.
Oh, okay.
DeAndre Mathieu. A 9-0 run for the Gophers. Wisconsin, though, Sam Decker. There they are, 53-42 in the second. Must-win situation there for Minnesota. We are at halftime, 48-46. Oh, it's got an NCAA tournament feeling, Casey. Semifinal, Seton Hall fresh off that upset win over top seed in the tournament. Villanova taking on a Providence team currently in Joe Lenardi's last four in. Providence out without a win, according to Mr. Lenardi. LaDante Hinton has got 15 in the half. Here's another bucket. Friars up at the half, 38-34. 21 points for Perry Ellis.
This halftime report is presented by Buffalo Wild Wings, the official hangout for NCAA March Madness.
We'll get you set for the NCAA tournament with our tournament countdown. First, the NIT selection special, and then the experts. 9 o'clock Eastern time on Sunday. Everything you need to know to help fill out your brackets. We'll give you a head start now. Here are some bracket tips.
Bracket tips.
My bracket tip: be objective, be organic, and any team that begins with a D and ends with an E, that's four letters. Located in Durham, North Carolina. Duke! Duke!
St. Bonaventure has 16 letters, and they were a grade A today against St. Louis. Look at this. Jordan Gathers knocking down the three for the win. Mark Schmidt, the head coach, said probably one of the biggest shots in St. Bonaventure history. St. Louis has lost four of their last five. So here's your last four in, first four out, according to Joe Lenardi. There you see, last four in. Nebraska, despite the loss to Ohio State, stays in the field. Dayton loses to St. Joe's. They're still in the field.
Well, look at Minnesota. That's why it's going to be a huge game for them. They've got to continue to try to win games.
All right, currently we've got Kansas, we've got Ohio State. By the way, Perry Ellis so far 21 points here at half. Kansas is 8-0 when he has 20 or more.
First one to 80 points. This is going to be a fun second half. Both of them are going to throw caution to the wind.
First one to 80.
First one to 80.
Might hit 100 here. Enjoy the second half.
Big 12 championship. At halftime of our first semifinal game between Kansas and Iowa State, with the Jayhawks holding a two-point lead in a very emotional, tough, high-scoring basketball game. And Fran, I had a quick opportunity to talk to the officials. They said originally they called the technical. He wanted the foul called on Tariq Black, just what you said.
Yep.
He was pointing at the clock. He was trying to lawyer up that it was okay for him to be out on the floor cursing because it was going to be a media timeout.
Only his second technical, it should be pointed out, in his career at Iowa State.
All right, so let's take a look at Perry Ellis. What a magnificent first half. These are the Shelter Insurance first half highlights.
Well, he only took 10 shots, Brent, but he ended up with 21 points. If you're going to be Fred Hoiberg's defense in the second half, you better be able to double him quickly. Well, take a look now. If you don't come quickly on the double team, he's going to hurt you via the pass or the basket. He can score inside and out. He did a terrific job on the glass. What I love about him is he uses both hands. 21 points just about a week ago or two. 32 is career high against TCU, so he's right on track.
I did a game in this town that a lot of folks might remember, a national championship between Kansas and Oklahoma. We were tied at 50 at the half. Got inside, and Black has it stripped by Kane and knocked out of bounds. Nice move by number 50. So there's Perry Ellis tonight versus the first half a year ago against Iowa State. That's the whole game, okay, against Iowa State. So a magnificent half here.
Like the eighth time this year, he's gone over 20. Right now, they're going to pack it in. Iowa State try to swarm the ball. Good example right there.
Edge him on the double team, able to knock it out of bounds with just nine. Now remember that we've only got 9 seconds on this shot clock.
This deep in the clock, look for an isolation, maybe for Wiggins out top.
Here comes Wiggins, rises up on hold, off the iron, and Kane. And now Holly, what did Coach Self have to say?
Well, he likes their offensive performance in the first half, that they've scored so well. He looks for Wiggins to insert himself more in this game in the second half, but he was mad about their defense, that they gave up 8 threes on just 12 shots. He said, I've got to believe the law of averages will be more in our favor in the second half, but we've got to guard better, particularly on our ball screen defense.
Well, they did guard better right there. Wiggins came away with it from Edgem, got it back, attacked on the drive, won't stay down. Long rebound, Tarik Black coming back. And finally, Niang cleans it out.
That's the first rebound of the game for Niang.
Kane with a pass inside, and home, sticks it home. What a game he's having at both ends of the floor here tonight.
Bill Self's not going to be happy, Brent, about that transition defense. That's why Hogue got behind the defense and got the basket. They're trying to spread Iowa State out right now.
Wiggins still can't find his shot. And Niang is fouled. That's his second foul.
The first couple possessions, Iowa State has packed it into the paint and dared Kansas to shoot the jump shot. They've taken the bait twice.
They load Niang on Black. Black, remember, with two fouls. Niang kicks it over to Hogue. Hogue will put it down on Ellison, drive. And then Niang with that inside-outside game missed the shot that time. Ball is out of bounds, and it belongs to the Cyclones.
Brent, I know the three is part of Niang's game. 33% of his shots are behind the arc. But I think early in this half, you must reestablish what they did in the first half. Take it back inside.
And here is Niang doing just what you said. And he draws number three, I believe, on Wiggins. That's it. Now Bill Self is forced to make a move. And Green is up.
Now this is going to put a little more pressure on the offensive end for Perry Ellis to continue to do what he did in the first half.
Kane knocks down the three.
This is no surprise, Brent. He's been doing this all season.
Turn it over.
Numbers.
Back to Edgem. He thought about the transition shot. Crowd wanted probably at least the Kansas Jayhawk part of that crowd. Here's Kane now off of.
See, I think Niang should roll to the rim and post.
There he is, and he got fouled. Just when he traveled first, that's the third time that I remember him traveling.
Yes,
in this
it
game.
Is. Yep, and I think he got away with a couple also. But Doug Sermons had a really good look. And remember, Niang's so active in there, he's going to watch his feet if you're the official.
And it's a sixth turnover against seven assists for the Cyclones in this game.
That means three of those were the travels, right?
Absolutely.
Here's that quick double.
Selvin off the iron. Defensive rebound by Hogue. Morris weaves his way in.
Got a mismatch in there.
Edgem loads Hogue. The fade on Green is just a little short. He had a good look at it.
Yeah, I would have rather him driven Green a little bit instead of settling for that fadeaway. Looking for that angle on that post feed, Brent.
Double Edgem tried to come around and knock it away.
See how they're trying to corral Ellis.
Selvin. And going down is Kane as Selvin came out of there.
Remember, Selvin has some buddies on this team, this Iowa State team. He and Niang were high school teammates at the Tilton School. Of course, Edgem and Tharp also teammates at Brewster Academy.
Tennessee checks back in, and they're going to rest Niang for a bit here. Fred wants to take him over and talk to him a little bit about the game out there, 51-48.
All you want from Edozie is just good defense. Don't foul. Rebound the ball.
Jayhawks looking for scores. Yes. Remember, Wiggins has three fouls. Selvin. And he finishes.
Well, he plays tough. He is tough.
The emphasis defending Ellis here in this half. You can see that. So Selvin needs to step up with Wiggins at foul trouble. And it is good. And one, Edozie contributes his first field goal of the evening.
How about that? He's only taken 12 shots all season long. Now 13, and he's made nine of them. This one gets blocked into the basket.
Foul trouble for the Jayhawks. Black is out with three. Wiggins watching with three. Embiid can't play because of the back injury. Now the Cyclones should do exactly what you've been preaching all game.
Keep going inside.
Nice contribution. Good looking stroke at the free throw line. Another big body out there. So here we go. Jayhawks trail it by four. Tharp comes in, and there was a whistle as he cut around the corner. We'll take the break here at the 15:52 mark. First of our two semifinals, Texas Baylor next.
watching Championship Week, presented by Dick's Sporting Goods.
Well, now it's Bill Self's turn, Fran.
Absolutely. This is called posturing right here. One good discussion with the officials deserves another.
Three team fouls this half against the Jayhawks and two against the Cyclones.
Two guys that were competitive, tough, hard-nosed, Big Eight players.
That's a foul situation for Kansas, especially with Embiid sideline. And so let's see who they can come up with. Ellis now a point of Memphis. Edgem with Wiggins out. Edgem switches over to Ellis. You can see number three down low. And he's all over Ellis. Ellis turns and they double him. And he's fouled on the shot. And from behind, I believe Naz Long got him.
What makes that move so good is that Ellis made his quick move before the double got there. When you double team in the post, you must come on the flight of the ball and get there on the catch.
Let me correct myself. It was on number three. So Perry Ellis to the free throw line. Jayhawks are really struggling trying to find field goals here in the second half.
Exactly. No Wiggins tonight so far. Seldon's a guy I think can give him some baskets, Brent. He's had three games this year, 20 or more.
Ellis with 23 of the Jayhawks, 52 points here tonight.
Oh, I like that.
Kane puts it down, attacks and rolls it in.
That's inexperience by Brandon Green. Kane took him to the screen and rejected it.
And that's no Black, no Trailer, no Embiid. Wiggins is going to come back in with three fouls. They've got to find some firepower.
Yep. You know, I was thinking at halftime, Brent, this is such a great game for Kansas. They're likely going to be on the two line. Outside chance at the one, but I doubt it. They played the toughest schedule in college basketball this year. You know what? They could use another tough game like this going into the NCAA tournament.
Well, they got one on their hands now. And Oklahoma State sent them to overtime, and now they get it away from Wiggins.
Well, Wiggins also got away with a little hook, but no harm, no foul.
The great ones just keep coming, and somehow they will shake off a bad game at some point.
You got the senior and the freshman.
Wiggins is on Edgem, and Edgem puts it down on him, and he kicks back outside. Seldon got there quickly on Naz Long that time, and so Kane, the three, yes, knocks down another one.
Man.
So we will take the timeout. Cyclones build a 7-point lead. They once led this game by 9. Nothing but net. We'll be right back after this message from your friends at Phillips 66. Six Big 12 Championship. It's part of Championship Week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Iowa State leading Kansas. Holly, I can't imagine that Coach Self is very happy.
Well, during that last timeout, he asked his guys, he said, look at the scoreboard. He glanced up there. He said, we've scored exactly 4 points since halftime. Now, you think about that, guys. We have absolutely no juice out here. We're playing with no pace on offense. Let's go. It's time to start competing. Andrew Wiggins was shaking his head. Yes, yes, yes. During that whole timeout, saying, yeah, coach, you're right. We'll see if he gets more engaged.
Fran, Holly should think of coaching. She did that very well. Right?
There's no question. She probably sat next to Perry Ellis in that last timeout. That's how close she gets.
Foul is called against Iowa State.
Well, they did try to go to Andrew Wiggins on that possession.
So Edge picks up another foul and non-shooting foul, ball out of bounds, and they put it into Selvin's hands. And here is Wiggins trying to shake it. Lucy runs right into the blocking foul is called. Hogue did not get set. Wiggins quickly took it to him.
That's another time they put the ISO. I don't know what a block of charge is anymore, because that's legally guarding right there. Once you've established that you're in front of the offensive player, it's up to the offensive player to avoid contact. That's just the rule. But I love Wiggins' aggressiveness.
Two fouls on Hogue. As we watch Wiggins, let's take a look at tonight's Wendy's Wooden Watch for the Player of the Year in college basketball. And one of our finalists is right here, the freshman from Canada, Andrew Wiggins.
You know what, Brent? Those 29 free throws are an indication of how aggressive he's been the last few games.
Cyclones lead is 13-54. Wide open. Beautiful feed to Niang. And that time he didn't miss from close range.
And you wonder what Traylor in those two fouls, if he just didn't want to pick up a cheap one.
Wiggins trying to become a little more aggressive with the dribble drive. This is Traylor's turn, and he takes it in for the layup.
He's amazing, Brent. He's shooting about 75% on the season. He never takes a bad shot.
Traylor on Niang, who backs him down. Spins back right hand, kisses it off the glass. Good move.
Very patient. The danger for Kansas is he also has 7 assists tonight from the low post. So how do you guard him?
Now we're inside of 13 minutes. Iowa State trying to shake a 5-game losing streak at the hands of the Jayhawks. Off the dribble, Wiggins spins paint short. Got his own miss back and scores.
You know that reminded me of? You remember the play at Kansas State?
Absolutely.
When he jumped twice? He jumps twice quicker than most guys jump once.
He has a very quick jump off his
miss. Yes, he does.
Missed attempts. He does a very good job of following the miss. The three, long score. What a huge hoop. Wiggins starting to come alive. And Long really contributed off the bench against Kansas State. Drains a three ball.
He's been red hot the last 3 or 4 games.
Screen outside by Traylor. Edge rebounds the Wiggins miss. Black and Mason will check in at the next opportunity for Kansas.
Might as well go back to Niang. They couldn't get it to him.
So Niang will take it himself on the drive, and it's knocked out of bounds. We will take the break at the 11:39 mark. Cyclone leading favorite Kansas. We welcome you back to Kansas City, 66-57 Iowa State over Kansas. And a reminder that today's game is brought to you by Puerto Rico Tourism Company. Live your own star vacation story. Puerto Rico, the all-star island. Visit seapuertorico.com. Here's Niang. Jump hook. Didn't get the roll. Wiggins with a defensive rebound. Mason now operating at the point.
You see that quick double team. Even Black, they'll double because they don't want Niang to pick up a foul one-on-one.
Having a hard time getting a good look here inside 10. Mason, dribble drive, and outstanding performance by the young point guard. His first field goal of the game. When all else fails, let the point guard take it to the hole.
Some of his best games this year have been against teams like Duke and San Diego State, Villanova.
Now it's Niang's turn, right hand. Drives it in at the other end.
Brent, right now they are carving up this usually tough Kansas defense. They are shooting over 50% for the game.
Embiid is missing. And oh, how the Jayhawks miss that presence. 7-footer down low. Hope he's able to play in the NCAAs. Ellis without a field goal in the second half. However, this time, and there's a foul.
And Bill Self does a good job of putting Perry Ellis at that top of the key where he loves to drive. Take a look. He can go both ways. Good concentration to get the old-fashioned opportunity at a three.
His earlier 2 points were free throws, and he's back on that line. He could be having a career game here. His career high is 32, and he's already got 26.
If you're Kansas now, you've got to figure out a way to get some stops.
Deep three by Edgen, and there's a stop. Missed three. Mason quickly to the attack.
They won't guard Black at the top. Niang will try to float in that lane and double team.
Knock it away from Mason. Loose ball. Scramble pickup. Turn it over. Here comes Long.
Oh, nice.
Great pass. Hard. Beautiful second pass by Edgen, the player of the year.
Transition defense, Brent. We've mentioned it a couple times. KU does not get set.
Wiggins drives in. Tap back man. Good with the left hand.
See how quick he got up again? Does Wiggins sweat?
We haven't seen it. Niang, ball fake, into the paint, now pass again. And Edgen is on the free throw line. That's on Black, and that's number 4.
Take a look, Brent. We remember this play at the end of regulation. Look how quickly he gets back into the play. He's just a phenomenal athlete. Another opportunity right here, the miss, and then the double jump again. And we've seen some of that tonight. That's just tremendous, tremendous athleticism.
Edgen with a dozen points. This, of course, right now in this game. And watch him stay with it with a left hand.
You know, he's not having a great game, but I love his aggressiveness tonight. I love the fact that he wants to take over the game.
Time for Mason at the point. Tharp is out there with him. So they've got both of the guards in that backcourt. Hogue knows he's got his hands full with Wiggins right now.
He's trying to get Ellis
isolated.
Gotta
let Wiggins touch it, and they don't. But that's a foul on Edgen. On the pass to Ellis. Number 3. So we'll see if he can nail the front end here, friend.
Yep.
missed it.
Hogue got the rebound. Niang's taking Mason into the post.
Morris stays with it. Not there. Offensive rebound. Fire back outside. And underneath is Morris. Look what I found on the right side. Because of the bad miss, he happened to be right man at the right place.
And you know who got that offensive rebound? Adozie, a young man who's played very sparingly in Big 12 play. Great effort.
Had a couple of good moments here.
Yes, he has. See if they double.
Wiggins down the lane. Back on that free throw line. And Adozie picks up the personal. We're going to be right back. 73-64, Iowa State. But can they close? We're back after this message from your friends at Phillips 66. Phillips 66, fueling the neighborhood with performance gas and just about everything else, like we have been for the last 80 years. Phillips 66, proud to be here. Kansas City, Missouri. What a great venue for the Big 12 basketball tournament. We'll be back here for sure for the next couple of years. We've had a sellout crowd on hand for both days. Baylor and Texas will be our second semifinal, and then tomorrow night, the winners will meet for the championship. Wiggins stepping up to the free throw line, and Fran come alive here in the second half. Dozen points, 4 of 6 at the line. He struggled a little bit at that free throw line. He's now 4 of 7.
Yeah, he's been reliable. He's been reliable most of the year, over 75%.
Remember, he put up 30 yesterday against Oklahoma State in that overtime win. Yang take it out of bounds. 8-point lead.
Yeah, Bill Self wants to change the tempo. They showed a little token pressure, but not much. They back off. That's the inside.
Yang's there.
That's what we call an ATO, Mr. Musburger, at a timeout play.
And we know who's outstanding at that. Hove all over Wiggins. Trailer, but it was going to go out of bounds. I see now there.
Watch Niang right here.
The ball, I believe, is going to belong to Kansas. It is.
That cut back screen by Naz Long right to the rim after the timeout. Good pass. Both coaches very good in those timeout situations.
20 on the shot. Dark rises. Got his elbow. That's Morris that got him. That's number three on Morris. Foul situation is getting a little dicey for Hoiberg and the Cyclones. Now, nobody has four, but they've got a lot of fouls. There's 19 fouls against Iowa State here this half.
Well, this guy at the foul line, we haven't mentioned him much tonight, Dark, but he absolutely is one of the keys to Kansas making a run in March. He has struggled lately. Kansas has struggled as well because of that.
Edozie and Long check out for Hoiberg. And Niang showing some leadership, Holly, in that last timeout.
Well, you know, he's getting so much great positive feedback. He's talking to his teammates. They have such good communication in their huddles. And his teammates are saying, George, they can't guard you. Keep going hard. Keep going hard. We just saw him score coming out of the timeout. I will say, though, his teammates are getting on him on defense, saying, you got to get back on defense. Great communication for them.
One of the reasons, Brent, they're having trouble guarding him is because there's no Joel Embiid inside.
Here is Neal. Back and down trailer. Here he comes again. And they can't guard him.
Nope. There's no presence at the rim for Niang. He's like a knuckleball pitcher, you know. He comes at you from different angles. Ball moves around.
Trailer with Niang on him. Stayed with it.
I don't know if he traveled, but I'll tell you this. Trailer really did a good job of keeping his composure through the contact. Really well done. Good patience by the young guy, a sophomore.
Niang again. Kisses it off the glass.
Wiggins tried to come over. He got there a little late.
12 of his 23 coming this half for George Niang.
Kansas cannot guard Iowa State right now. They need some answers.
Offensive rebound. Ellis coming back and scores. Timeout.
How about Perry Ellis? He's missed one shot tonight, 11 of 12 from the field. It's hard to get the ball to Ellis down on that low post because they're double teaming him. So he's got to be more active and move around in that offense.
Our first doubleheader here tonight at the Sprint Center. And then following that will be Baylor and Texas. So Baylor trying to make it three in a row, Fran, and that's not an easy task for any team.
Well, it's not, but they are playing as well as anybody in this conference right now. People had the Bears left for dead about a month ago. Scott Drew's rallied the troops, and Rick Barnes' team took apart West Virginia for the third time last night. Both of those teams played great defense, particularly in the zone.
And then our championship game tomorrow night is 8 local here in Kansas City, or 9 Eastern, 7 o'clock out in Montana.
Absolutely. They'll be watching in the Bitterroot Valley, won't they?
You bet. The Grizz knocked out of the Big Sky tournament. So Kane will bring it up to the attack here for Iowa State. They've got a 9-point lead. They've got 6 minutes on the clock. Self, as you could tell when you watched him and he went to that timeout, he's still very unhappy defensively with the inability to stop them. There they deflect the ball. Sloppy play by Kane. Turn it over. Here's Wiggins. Coach will like that.
Well, they need a few more of those stops.
Ellis has been the big man on campus.
See, they trapped him right out of the low post.
Wiggins off the drive. Beautiful drive.
That's important. I love his intensity over the last week or two.
Crunch time for the Cyclones. 5 minutes, 7-point lead. The Jayhawks have had their number. And now it'll be Hoiberg's turn to kind of calm things down, get them together, see what he can come up with 21 seconds left on this shot clock.
How'd you like this explosiveness? Remember, his mom was a track star. She was an Olympic medalist in 1984. Watch the quickness to the rim.
That mom is the reason why Florida State thought they had a good shot to recruit.
Yes, yep. Marita Payne Wiggins, and of course his dad Mitch Wiggins played in the NBA. You know, if anything, Brent, when he arrived on campus, he was almost too nice a young man. He deferred to his teammates, and it's finally in his head that he has to be the guy that takes over.
Interesting number here. If Iowa State stays ahead, Kansas is down to its last timeout. The Cyclones have three. Another shot clock's inside of 20. Niang takes it down on target block, and it's deflected out of bounds with 15 on that shot clock. Wiggins knocked it out. So Black, number 25, is playing with four fouls, and he's going to take a crack at Niang. Who's going to crack first? Will it be Tarek or will it be Niang? Niang's going to keep it on the drive. Float one on him.
Hey, Brent, you think they're playing through Niang right now?
Absolutely. Deflected, turn it over.
Numbers.
Back to Edgem. Yes.
Monty Morris gave it up at the right time.
That's the largest lead of the evening for Iowa State. They are up 11 at the 4:30 mark. Seldon kicks it back, turns it over. Morris got it on the intercept. Edge again, and he's on the free throw line for a pair. The turnover led to that.
Now the freshman Monty Morris shot the gap again. Came up with the ball, and Edgem just took off the other way. This is a deep, balanced team. Look at the steal by Monte Morris, and then gets it ahead to the senior. And Ellis has to just commit the hard foul.
Veteran move. Make sure you're in the act of shooting.
Oh, great, great point.
Shoot a pair. Boy, you see, you wonder if Edge, he's just a little undersized for the NBA. He's obviously going to get a good look by somebody, and if that doesn't work out, he'll make a lot of money in Europe.
Oh, yes,
let me tell you that right now.
Yep.
He's a big man with great range. He's very intelligent. You love his game. Good rebounder.
Guarantee you he and Andrew Wiggins will be on that Canadian national team for a while, right? Coached by Jay Triano, who's the uncle of Brady Heslip.
Heslip will be with his uncle, right?
I think at some point, absolutely. Jay is assistant coach at the Portland Trailblazers right now.
And it's a 12-point Iowa State lead. The Cyclone fan base, you can hear them. There are thousands here. Mason. And an easy putback for Tarik Black.
Bill Self's gone with the freshman Connor Framkamp from Wichita. First action of the night. He can shoot the ball. Hadn't had a great season behind the arc.
So he's searching for the long ball. Edge is going to put it down attack. He knows that Tarik Black is saddled with five fouls. Wiggins has had hold on him all night. Drives. And scores on Niang. Niang was forced to pick him up, backed off a little bit. It's a 10-point advantage. Wiggins, 17 now.
Remember, Kansas gave up 90 on Saturday in Morgantown. About to do that tonight. This is not typical.
And a whistle. Looked like Mason picked up the foul away from the ball, and so we'll take the break here. 3:23. Can the Cyclones close? We'll find out.
Tonight's Big 12 Network game has been brought to you by Phillips 66. Proud to be here. The Quicksilver card from Capital One. Earn 1.5% cash back on every purchase. Wendy's new ciabatta bacon cheeseburger, available at participating Wendy's for a limited time. Buick. Visit your local Buick dealer to see why thousands of people are switching to Buick. Buffalo Wild Wings, the official hangout for NCAA March Madness. Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. And by Dish.
Iowa State basketball. Kane, who is 5 of 6 shooting the three ball, inbounding the ball, and here's Morris. Niang with a huge game, 25 points. He's holding the ball right now.
He's being guarded by Selden for the first time.
Milking a little bit to bring it inside of three. Now it's Kane on Mason. Off to the side. Off the iron. And that'll go over to Kansas. Wiggins is back in.
Plenty of possessions left, Brent, but Bill Self's got a hurry up offense right now that he'll use. Look for him to spread the floor with the four guards and attack. This is your 2-minute offense, basically.
Mason penetrates, keeps coming, and underneath Ellis has gotten to the free throw line. Fouled by Edgem.
That's exactly what Bill Self wanted. Try to score with the clock stopped. He's got a small, quick team out there that can defend in the full court.
That puts Edgem with four fouls. So that is very, very big. He's a huge, huge presence for the Cyclones.
I can guarantee you Bill Self will stretch this game out. Here comes that pressure. High school teammates, Brent, Selden and Niang.
Knocked away from Niang. Saved. And here's Morris. Shot clock winding down in Kansas all over. Niang, lob pass inside to Hogue, who's triple teamed, and he's on the free throw line.
Well, Niang wanted to throw the lob to Hogue, but Monte Morris was cutting to the basket, and Hogue couldn't jump.
Again, Hogue has been the unsung hero because of the overall defensive performance against Wiggins. It has been a magnificent job he has done against one of the best players in the country.
And you liked what he did yesterday as
well.
Absolutely.
Now 2-10.
Lots of driving ability out there.
And it'll be Wiggins kicking to Green. Green is the driver this time. Rebound cleaned up by Hogue. Now they'll milk that clock.
I think they'll foul too, Kansas.
And Wiggins does just that. He fouls Morris. So Wiggins picks up his fourth at the 152 mark. And the defending tournament champions are in trouble. We're inside of 2 minutes. Morris is coming up to that free throw line for them. Let's take a look at George Niang. He's the player of the match, don't you think, Frank?
Yeah, no question, Brent. Remember back in January when he went 4-for-20 in Hilton Coliseum, 0-for-9 from three-point land? I think that stuck in his craw a little bit. He played better at Allen Fieldhouse, but today he's been absolutely outstanding. He understands the mismatches that his coach puts him in, and he really takes advantage of them.
It's interesting. I've seen players with unorthodox shots like that be very successful in the NBA. And he is unorthodox.
He is. I talked to Flip Saunders about this yesterday. He feels Niang has to get in much better shape. Similar to the way Kevin Love did. Look at that.
Oh, just over Edgem's head and out of bounds. Kansas basketball. That could have been the killer. And Hoiberg knows it.
Watch this now. They're going to spread it, drive it, maybe look for the three if it's there.
It'll be Wiggins. Spin. What a spin move. Missed it. And Edgem. yanks down to Reed. What a spin move on that attack by Wiggins, and he'll shoot two free throws.
This is what we talk about, a hurry up offense. I think from the time the ball came in till he shot it probably took 5-6 seconds.
When you've got a coach like Self and a team like the Jayhawks, this game is far, far from over. 7-point lead at the 142 mark. Cyclones had a golden opportunity and couldn't convert. Now Kane will bring it up. Gets it over to Morris.
Kane is a 64% foul shooter if they're thinking.
And they have to step in between Seldon and Kane. Seldon and Kane actually have exchanged a couple of shoves throughout this game. Let's take a look at our sixth man of the game, brought to you by Motel 6. And I am pleased with this selection. Oh, yeah. Why not a self? The fans of Iowa State, the sixth man of the game.
Well, we've seen great fans this year in the Big 12, certainly. Go to Allen Fieldhouse, Bramlage Coliseum, and they travel well down I-35 from Ames to Des Moines into Kansas City.
Their fans have been great, Holly.
Well, that's right. I actually checked with their ticket manager, and they have sold 3 times more tickets for this event this year than they ever have in the past. Actually, Fred Hoiberg was on Twitter with the hashtag Hilton South. They made a concerted effort to come down and support their Cyclones. See if it pays off tonight.
Oh, he lost it.
Oh, Deang turned it over. Up 7. Minute and a half to go.
I guarantee you, Brent, Kansas is going to shoot this ball quickly.
Cyclones do not want to foul here.
Which is all the more reason you drive it and look for the drive or the drive and kick three.
And it'll be Wiggins handing off to Green. And here comes Green into Deang. And a foul is going to be called. And look at this, blood all over. He needs medical attention.
Wow.
Let's get somebody there.
First of all, we want to make sure that Niang is okay. They're going to definitely sub for him.
Check the team here. Come on. Trainer's got him. Good job. Big play. DeAndre, let's get
it. Now Green is coming down. And it looked like an elbow inadvertently got in there. Did they plan on
absolutely.
This?
Absolutely, there it is.
You gotta love it.
Big 12 basketball, Brent. What a year.
Blood streaming from his face. Trying to snap that 5-game losing streak. Headed right off the floor toward the locker room.
Boom.
Right there.
Naz Long is in the game now. Now Brandon Green's got some blood on him from falling on the floor.
So they'll have to wipe that off before we resume play. And let's not overlook the fact that was a great play by Neal.
Exactly.
I mean, he stood in there and took that and was courageous. And the ball, as a result, is going over to the Cyclones, who are on their feet. So he takes the charge, walks off the floor bleeding, his team up 7.
Home run.
Long pass to Long, who gets rid of it, and now they'll play keep away and bring the clock down and force the foul. And that is on Wiggins. That's number 4.
That's going to put Monte Morris on the line, who shot over 80% this season. That was a good play by DeAndre Kane. He threw it up the floor, away from the pressure.
Ellis replaces Green. Morris has not yet shot a free throw in this game.
Tell you what, Brent, we've seen so many good young guards in the league this year. We only really took notice of this guy as the Big 12 season unfolded. He's so cool.
Two big free throws with coach's family coming to their feet. I imagine all of Ames, Iowa's on its feet. Seldon with a miss into Holmes' arms. Holm, not one of the better free throw shooters, and he got rid of it quickly. He got it out. That was very quick thinking, and Morris is coming back that free throw line again.
Oh, you're so right, Brent. Morris, over 80%. This kid won a state title last year at Flint Beecher, Mr. Basketball.
You saw Doc Sadler, the assistant to Fred Hoiberg, who was an assistant with Bill Self. Last year, he had been the head coach up at Nebraska. And Doc Sadler has been in Hoiberg's ear the last few minutes. He knows what the Jayhawks like to do coming down the stretch. And he's been a big part of his coaching staff.
He had that scouting report today. They had it buttoned up.
The upset is at hand. 1:06 for the Cyclones. Mason. Edge saves it, rifles it down, and gives it back to Mason.
They cleared the zone, like in hockey.
Wiggins misses, and Hogue again. Iowa State is going to the Big 12 championship. Start the celebration in Ames. Take it all the way to Des Moines.
This will be Kansas's ninth loss of the season. They played the toughest schedule in the country. They hope to get JoJo Embiid back soon.
He was really missed in this game today.
Without question.
Was it missed so much against Oklahoma State? Because they're not as big as Iowa State down in that low block. But here today, his absence was really felt. Wiggins comes up firing and knocks down a three ball here. In the final 30 seconds, Kane will bring it up. Playing keep away. A great feeling for Iowa State and their fans. The Hilton Magic comes to Kansas City. And the mayor with one of the biggest wins in conference play.
How do you think he'd do in a referendum tonight?
Even if they'd have lost, he'd have won for him. Do you understand? He's the mayor. Cameras are out. They will play either Baylor or Texas tomorrow night for the Big 12 championship. What a performance by the Cyclones. Take a look at our Phillips 66 player of the game, and we want you to see this warrior and his grand exit after he took a charge and had his face inadvertently split open, and with blood streaming Now watch what he does with the crowd. Now that's a warrior.
I'll be talking about this game for a long time up in Ames.
Players shaking hands. Iowa State moves on to our championship game tomorrow night against either Texas or Baylor. And we will check in with Holly Rowe and one of the great team leaders in Iowa State.
Well, Melvin, it has been difficult for your team to beat Kansas only four times in the last few years. Why was it you able to do it tonight?
Man, we knew how important this game was. We came out smart. We played our type of basketball. We got up and down the court. We just played our style. We were able to knock down shots, and we knew that we could win this game if we came and played the right way, and we did.
There was a point in the first half where Kansas started to pull away, and it seemed like you guys were losing control. How did you get it back?
Man, our team just has grit. You know, we have perseverance. We've been doing this all year against great competition, and this was another game. They got up in a little lead, and we were able to bring it together and just, you know, chip out away and take the lead. And then, you know, from there on, we just were killing. So it was a great job for our team, you know, great job for this program, and it was just a great win.
George Niang in the second half, you guys played through him. He was so good out there. What did you see that made you guys play through him?
Man, George is a mismatch nightmare. And, you know, he can score anyway, and he was just taking advantage of the opportunities that he had. And once he started going, everyone else started going, Johnny started knocking down shots. You know, big plays down the stretch, and we were able to get the win.
How do you not remain satisfied with this win and continue forward to win the championship?
We want a chip. That's our goal. You know, at the beginning of the year, that's what we wanted to do, and we got the opportunity now. We're in the final, so there's no letting up from here. We got to go with the same mentality we had today and go out and play hard and play our type of basketball.
Thanks, Melvin.
No problem.
All right, Holly.
Welcome into College Basketball Live Scoreboard. Matt Schick along with Adrian Brand.